Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, but Nick didn't know that one, so we had to go with Seaside. But we're sort of in our hearts, we've still got a little bit of Seaside, haven't we, even though we're in the middle of Derbyshire. But you can still imagine the sea, and if we get any more rain from the heavens, who knows, we might have sea. And there's always the lake, that's what I always see.
Oh no.
So it's really great to be with you again. Can't believe it's another year, can you? Doesn't it go quickly? They say that's a sign of age. Why I should be feeling that for a moment, I can't think, because I'm old.
Oh, yes, you are.
Am I?
Yes!
You are.
And you're not old, are you?
No.
Absolutely not. So, we are going to have a great week this week, aren't we?
Yes!
We are. And we're not going to ignore the elephant in the room. The elephant in the room being, this is going to be the last year. Okay? I'm just going to say that once, that's it. Okay, so we are going to make sure that this year is the best year ever. Yeah! Good. Well, tonight, just to tell you, it's a bit of an odd week this week because of the days, because normally it's Friday to Friday. So we're all totally confused, because it's now Monday to Sunday. It's like, woo, and it's a bank holiday thrown in.
Monday to Monday.
So, Monday to Monday. Oh, yes, sorry, some of you go home.
Yeah.
So I can't go. What do you mean I can't go home Sunday night? I'm going home Thursday night. You'll be pleased to know I'm not disappearing halfway through the week to go and see some amazing person do a concert. We won't mention that this year. It's a little bit confusing, and because bank holidays today, it was all a bit like, well, what are we going to do? So we thought, you know, nobody's going to travel on a bank holiday, you know. They're all going to sort of go, no, we're family, we want to travel on a bank holiday. So what we'll do, we'll sort of say people can turn up on bank holiday Monday if they want, but Tuesday will be the official start and all that. And we'll just do something just for the half dozen that will turn up on Monday night. How stupid are we? Hello? What time did you lot arrive? Some of you were here yesterday, camping out. So we should know that actually if you said it, you can come on Monday, that you'd all be here. So silly us. So what we're going to do tonight, we just thought we're going to have a relaxing evening, all right? And I know we've confused you because we put you around tables, all right? I always like to mess things up a bit, you know, don't make it too comfortable. So, you know, we're going to have a nice relaxing evening. We're going to introduce the staff like we normally do. We're going to do a bit of a quizzy night tonight. Interspersed with some singing, interspersed. We're going to sort of put the sing-along in with the thing. So it's going to be really relaxed. So tonight, just enjoy yourselves. However, I want to do one thing. I want to ban any electronic devices. See, I thought your generation wouldn't know anything about electronic devices.
Hang on.
How wrong I am. You're all Facebooking and texting and all sorts of things. So, when we have questions later on, I don't want any sneaking under the table. If we see any devices being used, out. And I have some very ugly bodyguards over here. Who will quite happily eject you from the hall, and you will be banned for 24 hours. So, don't push me, okay? Yes, what? Well, he's allowed because he's filming me. Anyway, we have a few changes of staff this year, and a bit later in the evening we'll be introducing the staff. But we are very, very thrilled to have a wonderful, wonderful lady this week who is going to sort of front, can I say that? Front the week. Some of you will know her from those of you who's been coming to Butlins for years and years and years. Well, sorry, New Horizons. Well, many of you will know this wonderful lady from many years back when she was part of the team. And we're really thrilled to have her here tonight. And so please give a massive, massive welcome to Major Valerie Milcrey. Yay!
So great to be back. It's like coming home. 26 years ago was my first experience of New Horizons. I pulled a man. Ooh. Peter and I had our silver wedding anniversary in June. Ooh. How old do you now feel? I do. I think I'm still a child bride, and then you realise, don't you? So good to have you here. It will be feeling weird for some of you, won't it? Because it's the first night, we all got a bit wet, you come in here, it's all round tables. They're not round tables, they're rectangular tables. So you're all sitting square round tables or something. It's great to be here, it's great to be back. Feels just like it always has done. Those of you who are currently with your back to here, can move your chairs if you want. It's a bit of a novel idea, I know, I put it out there. Just to save you being too worried. Great to see you. I also wanted to remind us, what do we do? What do we do at New Horizons? Does anyone have fun?
Yes.
If you push it. We have fun, don't we? We meet old friends, don't we? As in friends we've known before, not old. Nobody old here. We meet new friends. So we welcome you. If it's your first year, it really gets better than this. So if it's your first year, you are particularly welcome. But what I want us to do, because the difference of this week is it's a good old Salvation Army week. So in amongst all the fun and all the frivolity and all the madness, pantomimes, absolute nutty stuff, God is here, isn't he? So I wonder if you'd join me right at the very beginning to sing Lord for the Years. Do you want to stand or not? It's no. Because we've all been traveling all day. You can sing standing in your hearts. Lord for the Years, your love has kept and guided. Because for some of us it's a little bit sad, isn't it? We've had the word. When Keith said there's an elephant in the room, I'm about to run out and go, ta-da! And I realised it wasn't my introduction. There we are. Listen, let's sing together. Lord for the Years, my maestro at the back, I've said three verses. We don't mind which ones they are, but it always helps to have the first and last. I leave you to meddle with the other ones. Let's just live the room with a really great New Horizons focus welcome song so that we know why we're here. And we welcome God into this place. Let's sing together the marvellous Nick on the Keys.
Thank you.
just offer up the family prayer together, yeah? Because it's one that we know, it's one that binds us together, it's one that just focuses our hearts, and I'll throw the mic, don't worry Brian, not literally, I'll throw the mic back to Keith, and he'll chair us through the evening. But let's just pray together. Eyes closed or not, whatever's comfortable, because it's an exciting time. It's a weird start to a family week, but that's where we are, so let's share together. And we say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I'm going to hand back to Keith. That was for you, Johnny. Lead us not into temptation. That was your line, because we know what you're like. Back to Keith. Thank you.
It's only day one.
It's not even day one. It's minus day one. Anyway, as I said, we actually have had a few changes that have gone on staff-wise this year. Well, obviously, you all know that Mel retired earlier in the year. And we are thrilled because Lisa has taken over his role. Lisa, you will have seen around previous years. She's that the quiet one in the background that just makes everything tick properly. All right? And she is doing an amazing job. And we're really, really thrilled to have Lisa here tonight. Lisa, come and join me, please. Cammy's always hiding, there she is. Now, these four do an incredible job. I love working with these guys. I always go up to the sixth floor every so often and hound them, and they go, oh, no, Keith Turner's come up again. But it's always, we always have, they're always a great group of people to work with. They're very hardworking people. And I just want to thank you guys for all that you've done this year. They have had one of those years. You heard about a little thing called Congress Boundless?
Yeah.
These guys were right in the middle of all that. So they not only had to contend with all that and other events, but also putting together this week. So guys, thank you so much for all the hard work that you've done. It's really appreciated. Yeah. Lisa, this is not Lisa's comfort zone, all right? But there are one or two things she'd like to say with us at the start of the week.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
Thank you all for coming. It's lovely to see everybody. As Keith said, we work on this year in, year out, and you all know that. But it's always really great when it actually happens, because you think, well, actually, it has happened, and it's really good. So it's really lovely to see you. We didn't order the weather. We did order some garden furniture, which we haven't put out yet, but watch this space, because hopefully later in the week it will brighten up and you can go sit on the lawn. So, really, from our point of view this week, we want you to all go and see Camé in the information point, which is down in the Butterley Hall, where it was last year, at the back of the hall. And you can book up for the coach trip for this year, which is going on a bit of a Derbyshire tour, with a stopover in Matlock for lunch. So get your place, because places are limited, and last year we had a waiting list, so if you know you want to go, go and see Camé tomorrow. She's open from 9 till 5 every day, so go and book in for that. And also, if you would like Sunday lunch on Sunday, obviously, they're going to do the same as last year. The centre are putting on a three-course lunch, and it's priced at £9. So go and see Camé and you'll be able to book and put your name on the list, and we'll give you a ticket for your lunch. And what else do we have? I had to write it on my hand because I forget these things. Song request is the other thing. So during sing-along, if you've got anything you want to dedicate to a person, if someone's got a birthday or a special event that you want us to know about that's happening this week, let Camé know. And if you've just got any favourite songs you want us to include at any point, Camé's the person to see. Camé, do you want to talk? Camille's just reminded me, as she tends to do, we have got the newsletter again this week. Not tonight, because we kind of need to get some things put into it, but from tomorrow night, any announcements we've got for you, any news we want to share with you, a few quizzes, a few learning things about the staff team, all those things will be in the newsletter, which you can pick up after each evening session. So I think that's enough from us. Anybody else? That's it. That's us.
Now, we are really thrilled to be here at the Hayes Conference Centre again. We had a good time last year, didn't we?
Yeah.
And, you know, it was a bit of a change, and everyone thought, is it going to be the same? But, you know, I thought last year was a great year. I thought there were some really fantastic and positive things about that. And we're very, very grateful for the staff at the Hayes who really went out of their way to help us. It was something new for them. And they really worked hard to accommodate us. So we're really thrilled to be back here this year. And Peter is going to come and have a word with us, tell you some of the do's and don'ts, hopefully less more do's than don'ts. And so please, give him a welcome.
Thank you very much. I didn't realise I was following a comedian, so this is going to be very difficult. Andy also did a bit of dance. I don't really notice that. There's a little bit of dancing in there. Half of you are extremely lucky, as you're probably facing that way and can't see me. I am a year older, and as somebody said to me earlier on, oh, you're still here. I wasn't sure whether that was a compliment or not. But I am still here. And it is lovely, lovely to see you all. We had a great time last year serving you, and it was different, but we really enjoyed it. And we've made one or two little tweaks this year, so that hopefully you'll have an even better time with us than last year. I visited Butlins, I think it was 2 years ago, wasn't it? And I remember sitting on the stage at Butlins as you were all asking about chips, and various other things, and each time I started to speak, the thunder sounded, and I wasn't sure whether that was a bit of a message or not, but no thunder so far, just heavy rain. So you are very, very welcome to the Hayes. We trust that you have a very good week. I know you're extremely well organised with lots of good things going on. If there's anything we can do to help, do let us know via your folk, and we'll see if we can oblige. We have ordered, I think, slightly better weather as the week goes on, but we'll see it. I was slightly worried when you mentioned going up to the sixth floor. It sounds like MI5. Do you like that?
We've got nine floors.
Nine floors. Well, we've only got one floor here and nobody comes up to us, so there we go. So just to remind you, unlike Lisa, I have a piece of paper rather than the back of a hand. The code, if you come to a door that has a coded lock on it, the code for your stay is 1969. I wish that had been my birth year, but I was born a bit earlier. 1969. If the fire alarm sound, we don't do any drills at all, so if the fire alarm sound continually, if you just make your way to the old main conference hall, that's the white front of the building, I think, where you've got your shop?
Yes.
Yeah. So where you've got your shop. If you make your way to that building, we'll advise you when it's safe to return to wherever you come from. If that building's on fire, we advise you to avoid it. Through the night, and it'll be a different number each night, but through the night there is an emergency number that's posted up in the front entrance of each of the bedroom areas. So, should you need to contact anybody in an emergency, that's there for you. But please, only in an emergency, because it does get somebody up and they come and find you. So we won't be best pleased if you say, could I have some milk from the cornflakes? And lastly, we just want you to feel at home. I nearly said welcome home, because you were with us last year. But do please feel at home. This is your home for a week. This is your holiday, and it's extremely important that you relax and enjoy it. So from all of us at the Hayes, have a great holiday. I haven't got a joke to end on, so I'll just say, have a good time. Thank you.
Just be remembered, there's one more thing. Lost property. Do you have an issue with lost property sometimes? This is the first thing to be lost. Right. Does anyone recognise this lovely handkerchief? It's sort of lilac with some little roses on it. It was found at the back of the hall. If you're too embarrassed to, because it's one of the men, then do come and see me over. But it was found up the back. So if anyone's lost a lovely handkerchief, I'm sure it would like to find its way to a nice home. If it's not claimed, I'm sure it's not yours, is it? If it's not claimed, you'll have to go home with me. I'll leave it at the front, so if it is yours and you want to surreptitiously retrieve it later, that's fine. Now, we are very honoured this week because we have some very important people coming to visit us. And we have a very important person who's staying all week. Ooh. I'm not talking about myself or anybody else. But we are really thrilled this week to have Major Mark Herbert with us. He's loitering in the back corner in the hope that I actually am not going to call him up on his platform. However, Mark, if you'd like to come and join me on the stage. A year and a half ago, you were my immediate boss, weren't you? And now he's an even higher boss. So I have to be even more nice to him because, you know, I don't want to get the sack yet. Right. But Mark, it's really thrilled to have you here this week. And I know you're going to have a great time. You're probably going to have a bit of an ear bashing. I think you've already given him a bit of an ear bashing. Be kind to him. All right. He is a lovely gentleman. All right. But Mark is really pleased to have you here this week. And we're glad that you're actually able to be here all week. And would you like to have a quick word?
Thanks for the welcome. It's a great event. And I've been looking forward to being part of this week. As I wander around to coffee breaks, meal breaks, happy to have conversations with you, really. And if you've got questions, if you've got concerns, if you're not quite sure why we've made the decisions we've made, happy to have us. I'm not hiding, all right? And we'll have a good conversations about that. So it's great. I've only got one joke. Am I allowed to tell my joke?
Yeah.
I've got one joke.
Yeah, yeah.
And all I ask is that you laugh. Because whenever I tell this joke, no one does. So I'm just going to keep telling you wherever I go until people do laugh. So here it is, okay? What do Winnie the Pooh, Attila the Hun, and John the Baptist have in common? They all have the same middle name.
If you didn't get that one, it's the. Yeah? The. We need the poo. Oh, look, they went in themselves now over there. Okay. You're going to lead us in a song, apparently.
Apparently, I'm going to lead you in a song. Do you guys at the back know this? A Band of Salvation. Three verses. Any three verses. Apart from the verse about my tempers are fitful, passions are strong, we don't know really about it, we? Okay, let's go, shall we? Thank you. In your best open air voices, come on.
Oh,
you, Mark. I forgot to say that Mark's official title is Assistant Programme Secretary. Ooh. APS for short. Now, you may have realised that actually we're celebrating something very special this year in the Salvation Army. Yeah? 150 years?
Oh, yeah.
In case that's sort of passed you by. And one of the reasons why we've done O Bound of Salvation tonight, apart from the fact it's a really good song and a really good sing, is that that is our theme for our Bible studies this week. And what we've done is we've given each day a different verse has been chosen, and the Bible study will focus around the words of William Booth. So that's why we thought we'd do it at the start of the week, and I'm sure probably some point later in the week we will either sing the whole lot or sing some more of it. So, now it's down to you. We're going to have the first round of our quiz. Is that a moan or is that a...
Yeah.
I didn't think you were going to have to use your brains tonight, were you? So what we're going to do, hopefully you've sat with people that you know, but it may well be that the people on your table are complete strangers to you, or there may be people that you think, seen your face before, not quite sure who you are. So what we're just going to do, you have a couple of tasks you want to do. I want you, first of all, to greet everybody on your table. So you can wave, smile, do whatever. Hopefully find out their names. This could be the interesting bit. You need to give your table a team name. So between you, as a team, unity, working together as a team, you need to decide upon a team name. Alright? Now, we don't want to have the United Nations, we don't want to have like debates for 4 hours on this or whatever, but in the nicest possible way, discuss among yourselves what title you're going to give your team.
This is an equal thing, opportunity. Men have got up their say. Our point was permission to do it.
And then once you've decided on your team name, because you all have, haven't you?
Yeah.
You need to ascribe. So somebody who can write. There are going to be four rounds, and each round is going to have 20 questions. So you need to work out on your piece of paper, whoever's doing the scribing, whoever's writing, how they're going to make it legible for everybody else. So what I don't want is hieroglyphics that absolutely nobody else is going to understand. So you'll need to sort of put four rounds of 1 to 20 and rooms put the answers. Okay? This is where we see who the organised people are and where the people who are not so organised are. And you might want to write the name of your team at the top of your bit of paper. You've already done that? Intelligent lockdown here. Very intelligent. Have you done that? Right, Tony, we've got the intelligent ones up the front. Have you done it up the back? Can you see me? Oh, that's better. That's lovely. Okay, are we ready? Hands up if you're not ready. It's always that table. Always. Just because you just celebrated your grandson's birthday. Yes? Are we ready now? No. Am I still getting a no? Right, ready or not, here we go. I just need to get the quiz.
Hey, I'm not doing anything.
And it's the weakest link. So it's highly intelligent. I have been through these rounds. I was doing that sort of like, I decided that if I knew all the answers to the quiz, then it was probably a little bit too easy. And then the ones where I didn't know any answers, so that might be too difficult. So hopefully it'll be sort of in between, and you can put your brains together, and hopefully answer all the questions correctly. All right? So, are we ready? Round one. Question one. In music, yeah, and don't shout things out. I know what people... Oh, I know the answer! All right, none of that. Okay, do it quietly. You lot. In music, which composer wrote the water music thought to be for King George I's procession down the River Thames in 1717? Some of you remember that.
Not quite.
Don't quote
number 17.
In music, which composer wrote the water music? All right, that's question number one. Question number two. Which international organisation established the International Court of Justice? No mechanical devices, please. Which international organisation established the International Court of Justice? Put that device away, young lady, otherwise you'll be out. You'll be out. Bodyguards. Bodyguards. Bodyguards, we might have a throwing out in a minute.
It's an E-ring, we don't count.
That's one.
Put it into
mark, right? Any more? You'll be out. Right. Yes, do you want to just police the up and down? Because I'm sure some of you at the back...
I'm out here. I'm got behind you.
Question number three. Where in the body would you find the Sylvian fissure? Where in the body would you find the Sylvian fissure? There's a nurse over there and she doesn't know. Okay, question number four. Oh, this is an interesting one. In the animal kingdom, what is the common term for domesticated cavies or cavies? That's C-A-V-I-E-S. In the animal kingdom, what is the common term for domesticated cavies or cavies? This is round 16 in the book. It's not the difficult ones, apparently. Okay, question number five. In world politics, Mohandas Gandhi was a leader of the National Congress of which country? Mohandas Gandhi was the leader of the National Congress of which country? Okay, question six. In TV, some of you are TV buffs, are you not? Yes? What was the name of the US legal drama series starring Corbin Burnson and Jimmy Smits? It's going back a few years. In TV, what was the name of the US legal drama series? Hint there.
If I'm wrong, you can blame me.
Starring Corbin Burnson and Jimmy Smits.
Try Alan Law. Oh, yeah, the law, right?
Question number seven. Viticulture is the growing of which fruit? Viticulture is the growing of which fruit? So if I'm saying I'm going to viticulture, what fruit am I growing?
Sounds like an illness.
I'm not sure there's any clue in the title of that. Just guess. Okay, question eight. In 1993, some of you can remember that, which British athlete set the 110 metres hurdles world record in Stuttgart? In 1993, which British athlete set the 110 metres hurdles world record in Stuttgart?
Could have been Keith.
So intelligent now, are you? Well, there's no point in giving you all questions you're going to be able to answer. Okay. Question number nine. In theatre, for what does the abbreviation FOH stand? Okay, what does FOH stand for in the theatre? Of course, we need a theatre buff. This one's easy.
Yes.
Apparently, I'm being a bit long-winded.
Leave him alone.
Oh, yes, I am. Pantomime's tomorrow night. Yeah. Question number 10, I'm going to whiz it along a bit now. Okay. Omaha is the largest city in which American state? You either know it or you don't really, don't you? Question 11. Who painted Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatte? It's a very well-known painting. I'm sure you all recognise it if you see it. Who painted Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatte? Those of you that are musical buffs will know that a musical was written about it by Stephen Sondheim. Okay, question number 11. In human biology, what V describes the two lower chambers of the heart? Oh, you know that one, don't you? In human biology, what V describes the two lower chambers of the heart? Question 13. Which Norwegian city is located on the Aker River? That's A-K-E-R. Which Norwegian city is located on the Aker River? Okay, question 14. In football, Kenny Dalglish is the most capped player for which country? Okay, in the animal kingdom, a murder is the name given to which group of birds?
Yeah, so do we.
No clues, or we'll send you out.
Bodyguard.
Okay, question 16. In literature, complete the title of the 1953 Raymond Chandler novel. Anyone read the Raymond Chandler?
Not like you.
No.
No? Some of you are too young, aren't you?
Yeah.
1953 novel, The Long What? The Long What? Okay, so the title was The Long
Witch.
Something. Shut up. Sorry. Be quiet.
Okay, you're right, the person.
Okay, question 17. What is the name of the religious order for men founded in the 13th century by Sir Francis of Assisi? Okay. What is the name of the religious order for men, so that means sort of like a monks and that, founded in the 13th century by St. Francis of Assisi. Again, the clues in the name. Question 18, in computing, that. Where is it? You should know this one, if you don't, I'll be horrified. What is the name of the material that is most commonly used in the manufacture of microchips? What is the name of the material that is most commonly used in the manufacture of microchips? And it's not little potatoes.
Manure!
Okay, question 19. Who became King of Spain following Franco's death in 1975 and returned the country to democracy?
His son.
Who became King of Spain following Franco's death in 1975. And finally, question 20. In geography, what W is a part, oh, sorry, part, port on the coast, port on the coast of Cumbria in northwest England. Anyone from Cumbria? What, in geography, what W, that's a wuppa sound, is a port on the coast of Cumbria in northwest England? Okay, excellent. We will await the next bit. Hang on, I just need to find my lip. Okay, over to Valerie.
When you do the answers.
We'll do the answers all at the end. I'd like to keep you in suspense. Got another 4,000 rounds to go.
I wonder if Michelle and Therese would like to come up and talk to us about night owls. It's wonderful to have them here. We're going to go through the staff that are here so that you know what's happening. Can I, as they make their way to the front, ask if you can bear to, if it's your first year, could you just do this for me? You are so welcome. It's your first year. Could you bear to stand? Would that be a bit embarrassing? Because somebody near you would like to give you a hug.
Oh, yeah.
Mark, you're not standing, are you? Yes, yeah, somebody near you would let's give our first time as a really big welcome. What that looks like or what that means, but they're going to tell you right now.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Who usually comes to night owls? Yeah. Oh, that wasn't many, was it? We shouldn't have done all that shopping. If you've never been to night owls, this is your last chance to come. Okay. If you've never been before, you need to come and expect the unexpected. Now, our theme this year is Love It.
Yum, yum!
That's because we're going to eat lots of nice food. Will you pay attention over there, please? You can't come anyway, so it doesn't matter. You have to go to bed, you've been naughty. The second part is laugh at it. The third thing is live it. Now, if you don't know how to live it, we're going to give you some advice for that.
Yeah, I'm stuck on that one.
Yeah, you need a lot of advice. Okay, so if you like laughing at stuff and you like doing funny things and playing funny games, doing fun, this is the place to come and do that with us, okay? If you like eating, yay! Nice food, late tonight, tea and coffee, hot chocolate, fizzy drinks, you can come along. Where is it? It's where you're going. Where are you going? Up there. Where's up there?
In the dark, in the orchard.
Tell me it's the dark, I'm scared. In the orchard room, right at the very back, up at the top, okay? Come and see us up there for lots of fun, and we really look forward to seeing you.
What time is it?
So it's 10 o'clock tonight. Oh, is that good? And then if you've still got some energy left by Thursday afternoon at 2:30, you'll see the title is Above All Have Fun. And if anyone did come last year, we certainly did have quite a wet experience. We had a lot of fun. Hopefully we'll be outside.
So we'll see you there.
Yay! What can I say? Live and laugh and love in the orchard room. So that's for those of you who really don't want to go to bed particularly early. It starts at 10 o'clock. Lots of food, lots of fun, lots of fellowship, and something else. So that'll be marvellous. I'm trying to find something we could sing to encourage us about the things that happen right away from the morning, right away to the evening. I've gone for the Salvation Army's new songbook. I know, I love it. And Mick King was very involved in being part of that. So good on him.
Yeah.
Yes, and we're going to sing. I can can tell you the song, and then I'll see if you can guess what number it is. We'll sing in the morning the Songs of Salvation. What do you reckon?
222.
Oh, I do dislike people that do that. I also think you might like to know that 666 is hundreds of thousands. Yeah. It may not come up as a question tonight, but you'll be thinking of that in the middle of the night. You'll think, So, we'll sing in the morning. You know this lovely chorus, don't you? The morning and the evening, just to encourage you. While we're singing, could Tammy and Alison come to talk to us about food together? Just now, over to you. Oh my word! Jugs and cups and saucers. We're only actually providing the extra food for Matt, really, because if he doesn't have enough, he just has to keep going for a whole week. Is that right?
Right, folks, so if you need a bit of lunch to get you through the day, there is a cafe that's going to be over in the main house. It's going to be running from 7:30 till 3:30. Every day, it will be serving sandwiches, teas, coffee, chocolate bars, crisps, and cold drinks.
A burgers.
Wait for it. It's in the main house, in the gathering area. What's that area called? Outside the dining rooms. The old bar. The bar area is where the cafe is. Outside, when available, there will be burgers and hot dogs. There will be burgers and hot dogs served on the emergency vehicle. Now, just to let you know, this is an in-use emergency vehicle. If it goes, it goes. Okay? You will have to have a sandwich. So if you can't find it, it's probably gone.
Which moves us on to the evenings. Because you know what it's like, you've had your dinner, then you come in here, and then halfway through the evening you think, oh, could do with a sweet, could do a bit of chocolate, cup of tea, fizzy drink, just enough to keep you going for the rest of the evening. So every break in the evening, we'll be in the back hall, or some of us will be in the back hall, sports hall, and we'll have all those things available for you. You've got to pay for them, but they will be available. Yay. Does that sound okay?
Yes!
They won't go hungry.
Newsletter.
Oh yeah, just being reminded about the newsletter. Anybody who's got birthdays, anniversaries, special events, dedications, please let us know and we can pop those into the newsletter. So for the following day, we need to know the day before. And any special requests you've got that need to go in there, just to say thank you for somebody doing something or something has happened, we're quite happy to put those in there as well. So thank you very much. I'm going to hand back to Ben.
So
So you know where you can go to eat. You're not going to be hungry this week, are you? Boys and girls. Just remember, we have a sing-on at the end of every evening. This is evening, what we've done, because we're all a little bit tired, aren't we? We just thought we'd merge the two. So we're going to go straight from the quiz night into a bit of a sing-along into the epilogue so we can be free a little bit earlier to go and get our chocolate and fizzy pop. That's what I think. So that's what's going to happen this evening. But generally, Mark and I will organise sing-alongs at the end of the day. You know that on the programme you don't have to go to anything, but it makes sense to go to as much as you can, and we'd love to have you doing that. So the sing-along just rounds off the day nicely. And if there's any song that you want to sing, and there's anything that you want to be part of, if you want to sing a solo, it might be there's opportunity. So there are more opportunities later in the week, she says very quickly. So Mark and I will be taking that turn about. Any favourite songs or dedications, if you give them into Camé during the day, we'll try and feed them into the night. A few things you probably need to, if you want to give any gifts to any of the team members, that's fine. Can I just say, I like jelly babies, just putting it out there. I don't actually like the green ones, mention that, that's fair enough, you can eat them first. And also, if you want to do something with, like, Johnny's having a baby in 2 months. Just yay! Not Johnny personally. Baby it is. Can we tell them or not? Shall we ask Johnny? Right, first of all, how many of you think Johnny's having a little boy?
No.
They're putting you all on Facebook, aren't you?
Yeah.
Johnny's having a little baby girl in how many weeks?
9 weeks and 2 days.
9 weeks and 2 days. And did see lovely Whitney as we picked him up and said, what were the plans? Because babies came. Can't babies come 9 weeks and 2 days earlier? But it's okay because Johnny could go and he's got a little jumper to take, haven't you?
Yes.
Been given a little jumper already, so that's for the baby. Anyway, why am I telling you that? Anyway, so you know that you can be involved in the sing-along. So we want you as involved as possible so that you enjoy that. Here's Claire with the next round for your quiz. Let's go. The next 20 questions.
Right, just to pick up on what Val's just said, I like Maltesers, I also like crunchies, chocolate buns, like anything really. Just if you see me and you want to give me some chocolate, feel free. Okay? Who thinks they got 20 out of 20 on the first round? Oh, one person. Okay, so if you all get ready, we're going to go into round two. So, question one, thinking caps on. In Roman numerals, which letter represents the number 5? Oh, it's easy there. Everyone's chunter. So in Roman numerals, which letter represents the number 5? Question 2. In music, what name is given to a written symbol representing the pitch and duration of a musical sound? In music, what name is given to a written symbol representing the pitch and duration of a musical sound?
A blob.
Question 3. In law, what E is the name given to the documents or objects used to prove or disprove someone's case? So in law, what name is... Oh, yeah. In law, what E is the name given to the documents or objects used to prove or disprove someone's case?
I heard that over here.
If you're not sure of the answer, someone over here can give you the answer. All the answers this way.
We'd already written our statement.
Question 4. In art, who painted the Mona Lisa?
Banksy.
Question 4. In art, who painted the Mona Lisa? Thank you very much. Question 5. In a game of darts, what is the highest score you can achieve with 3 darts? So all you darts players out there, this is easy.
Yeah.
In a game of darts, what is the highest score you can achieve with 3 darts?
Not 100.
Not in a regular
Mr. Question 6. In fashion, what tee is a woolen fabric commonly used to make men's sports jackets?
Oh, I say.
In fashion, what tee is a woolen fabric commonly used to make men's sports jackets? Question 7. Blackfriars is a district in which city in the southeast of the UK? I think everybody heard that. So Blackfriars is a district in which city in the southeast of the UK? I think everybody got that one, thank you. Question 8. In which 1964 children's film did Dick Van Dyke star as a chimney sweep named Bert? In which 1964 children's film did Dick Van Dyke star as a chimney sweep named Bert? Question 9, you should all be on number 9 now. In the animal kingdom, which animal is usually larger, the wallaby or the kangaroo?
The kangaroo.
If you've been to Australia, you might stand a better chance. So in the animal kingdom, which animal is usually larger, the wallaby or the kangaroo?
Red.
Question 10, in music, singer Axl Rose featured in which American rock band formed in 1985? When I was just 2 years old. And some of these over here probably weren't even born. John wasn't even born. In music, singer Axl Rose featured in which American rock band formed in 1985? Question 11. In TV, Sybil Shepherd featured in the series Moon what? Oh!
He wasn't.
In TV, Sybil Shepherd featured in the series Moon what?
Come on.
Question 12. In food, consommé and gazpacho are types of what? In food, consommé and gazpacho are types of what? Food. Question 13. In which sport is the ball made of cork and twine and covered in red leather? Ooh. Question 13, in which sport is the ball made of cork and twine and covered in red leather? Question 14, oh, this is a maths one, I'm terrible at maths. In geometry, how many right angles does a right angle triangle have? Question 15. I like this question because it's about one of my first crushes. What character did Leonardo DiCaprio play in the 1996 film Romeo and Juliet? Juliet.
Oh, we heard that over here.
What character did Leonardo DiCaprio play in the 1996 film Romeo and Juliet?
Rosal Garmage.
Question 16. In nature, common house and blue bottle are both types of which insect? So that's common house and blue bottle are both types of which insect? Question 17. In athletics, in which event did Linford Christie win a 1992 Olympic gold medal? So, in athletics, in which event did Linford Christie win a 1992 Olympic gold medal?
Bring back my pony to me.
do videos, can you let me know? Because holding my stomach and doing all that at the same time is really difficult. So if we can just try again, I'll just hold everything else. We're going to start with our arms up this time, okay? Now let's see if we do it. Every time there's a bit, all right, let's see if we really can do it. And if there's nothing, you just hold, all right? We're all right?
My body lies over the ocean. My body lies over the sea. My body lies over the ocean.
Here we go.
So bring back my body to me.
Someone else who is. I want you to put your hands together for Gary Rhodes. Gary's doing everything this week, aren't you, Gary? Singing,
like it.
Dancing.
Why not?
Banding.
Banding, definitely.
Male voice choiring.
Yes, definitely.
Tell us, where do they need to? Isn't he gorgeous? Yeah. Where do they need to be to see more of you?
Well, if you'd like to see more
it's
of me.
Late. Sorry.
That's before she starts.
I know.
Tomorrow we start band practice 10:30, I think. Is it 10:30? In here. There's two things I don't like. It's late people.
Oh, I'm not dead.
And Russian dolls. I don't like Russian dolls because they're full of themselves.
Yeah.
Come for more of that tomorrow morning. I've got something to. Well, you see this flag over here? Apparently, that was made for New Horizons. Well, this is a very special year for the band, and I'm honoured to be a part of the New Horizons
it's
band.
Down.
This flag.
Australian.
Has been made for the New Horizons band.
Oh.
By a fella, I think he's here. His name is Richard Borrett.
Yes.
Richard!
So we will wear that with pride. Thank you very much, Richard.
Tomorrow morning. Anything else you want to say,
Mel Voice? Yes, tomorrow afternoon. If you're a bloke and you like singing, 2:30.
Or if you're a woman with a very low voice. I sound more like you all the time, don't I?
Yeah, you
do. Yes. There's a real winning there.
2:30 in. Is it Tissington?
What?
I misheard it, but. Tissington.
Just say the room again.
Tissington, yes. Tissington.
Tissington.
Which is down the bottom, apparently. And one of the.
Somebody say go on, please. It's getting really late, isn't it? We need to go. Oh, this is a real preamble for the epilogue. Sorry.
And there's one more thing.
No, please, no more.
Denmark is not the furthest travelled country.
No.
Because there's somebody here from New Zealand.
No. Who's here from New Zealand? I didn't know you're here from New Zealand. Fashion checks. That's a terrible time. Have you stayed over from WAGS? Have you actually gone home at all? So you came for WAGS, you've gone to Boundless and you're here. You're a total nutter, aren't you? You are so welcome, our friend from New Zealand.
Yeah.
Just as well you didn't get our prizes because the French and Denmark would have eaten them. They'd have to bring them up to give to me. It is great to have you. We're here. You feel a bit more relaxed. Yeah, you feel ready for the toilet and a drink in bed. Yeah, I do. Brian's going to come and share with us. And what I'm going to ask is as he comes, for Nick just to play the song we were going to sing, we're not going to sing, but just to help us just emerge. Just to remind you, tomorrow morning, day starts with breakfast. And then prayers and Bible study. I'm looking at these. I think it's 9:15. And it's me tomorrow. I know, please be here.
Butterley.
In the Butterley room. Do you notice I waited long enough for somebody to check in the butter? This is the Derbyshire suite. The butter room is the big room on the way down near the dining room area. If you turn left from the bottom there, to the left there, that's the orchard room. And the Tissington room, don't, no idea. So we'll make sure we get
Lakeside.
Is that all right? So, it's going to be a great week. You know it'll be as good as you make it, don't you? You know that thing. So if on, when it comes to next Saturday, Sunday, when the Chief Secretary comes to do his thing, if any of you say it's been a miserable week, I'm going to smack you. Not obviously physically, but I'm going to say it'll be the sort of week you want it to be. I have to tell you that the guys, I'm not saying about myself and Mark, this is what we do, but these guys have taken a week off work to be here and bless you. You've arranged. Themselves already, and whilst we all keep it bright and breezy, there's a lot of stuff that goes on for everybody. So let's from the very, very beginning be gracious and loving and warm and caring, or I'll get the boys on to you. No, just let's make it the week we want it to be. Yeah, so I'm handing over to Brian. 1 minute just to breathe. Nick, who is such a gift to this place, is just going to play us a verse of Now the Day is Over, because it really is. Okay, he's just going to bless us with that, and then over to Brian for our closing moments and benediction.
Well, we've had a good evening. I think it's been great, don't you?
Yeah.
And a great start to the week. This is the epilogue, sort of a prayer time, bringing things to a close, a kind of summary, a conclusion. And yet it's the start of, it's the end of the first day, but the start of the week, and that prompted a couple of thoughts. And I've called it a two-way thing, and I'll hopefully in a couple of minutes just explain why. And it struck me, and I'll tell you who led the meeting in a couple of minutes, because you'll know them. But during a meeting maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago, this thought came to me as I listened to the sermon, and we sang a song. It was about prayer time. And it struck me that most of our prayers are asking for things rather than offering to do things for him. And that's, you see where I'm heading with the two-way thing? As children, we might have prayed simple prayers like, Lord, keep us safe this night, secure from all our fears. May angels guard us. And that's very nice, it's very simple, we've all used it, it's very appropriate. But you see how it's always asking for things to be done for us. And that's part of the process. Maybe as children we learnt, it comes from that, because we learnt to pray, God bless mum and dad, and help me do this, and help me do that, and can I have a bike for Christmas? Whatever. And that's part of praying. But it's also, dear Lord, what can I do for you? Which is why it's a two-way thing. And as adults, we start to change that. And we've often sung the prayer chorus, make me a blessing, you know the one? Out of my life may Jesus shine. Make me a blessing, Saviour, I pray. Make me a blessing today. You see how that's now changed round? That we're asking for guidance as to how we might help somebody else. And that's my sort of thought for this week. That maybe, of course, we'll receive. We've prayed as a team that we will all receive from God and be blessed and be encouraged. But it's also on us to bless others and encourage others. And I'll tell you which song it was, and it was led by Peter and Sylvia Dalziel, who you know we've had at New Horizons. And they happened to choose this song, and I'm not going to recite it all, but just try and think, or even take a look at Make Me a Channel of Your Peace. And this is a song that's been written in most of our lifetimes. It's not one that's several hundred years old. It's a new, relatively new song. But see if you can follow my thought process as I refer to a few of these lines. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there's injury, let me demonstrate your pardon. Right? And where there's doubt, let me demonstrate true faith in life. The verses all go on like that. So where there's despair, let me bring hope. Where there's darkness, please let me cast some light into somebody's darkness. And the Lord knows, and he does. You will each have the opportunity this week to do that. Sometimes we're so concerned with, you know, let me bore you with, you know, things that have happened to me. And maybe my ailments, and maybe this is the week when we'd rather say, enough about me, I'm concerned about you. What can I pray for you? Right? Rather than what can I pray for myself? And this is the ideal community when we might just do that for someone during this week. It's not so much about us being pardoned, but that we might pardon others in giving of ourselves that we receive, and then that we are born to eternal life. So that's all the challenges of this week. For us to, one, receive from God, and then in our own way, and Val's just said exactly that, for us to bring love and consolation, share our faith, our hope, bring light and joy. And even our benediction song is that twist. The first three lines, you know, and we'll sing them now. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace. God will give us his peace. But if our minds are stayed on him, if we are in communion with God, we take his spirit, but it's us to share. And this is a sharing week. We've all come to receive. Let's just make sure that we give of ourselves and give of our faith and give during this week as we now sing that.